Hi, and thanks for joining me on another Tom Did It video. My original intention was to make a quick and easy video showing you how to replace the rear hydraulic brake switch. You'll see that this escalates out of control into a full brake service and cleaning video. I'm sure most motorcycle enthusiasts can relate to this. The annual registration is due on the bike, and this requires a mechanic's inspection. Prior to taking it to the mechanic, I did a quick inspection of my own and found that the rear tire needed replacing, so I did that. And also the rear brake light wouldn't work when I pressed the rear brake pedal. To confirm that the rear brake switch was faulty, I started by pulling the front brake, as this will test and confirm that the rear bulb is working. The rear brake switch is located near the rear brake pedal. Carefully remove the wires from the unit and short the wires out using anything conductive. Here I'm using a bent paper clip, as it was the only thing I had handy at the time. By shorting the wires together, we can prove that the wiring network leading to the rear brake is okay. So this now indicates that the rear brake switch is faulty. I'd just like to say, be careful not to short this out to the frame of the bike, or else you'll blow the fuse. Bleeding brakes on your own can be quite time consuming. Here's a new tool I'll be trying out. Basically, it works by creating a suction at the brake caliper, then drawing the fluid through the line from the reservoir, and then collects within this little plastic jar. So with the reservoir now accessible and the cap off, you're ready to connect the suction tool to the rear brake caliper. Use a spanner to loosen the bleed nipple on the rear brake caliper and then start the suction. You can see bubbles in the clear pipe. That shows that the old fluid is being drained from the system.
There we go.
Just letting you know that for the next 5 minutes, I go on an obsessive cleaning spree. I'm also dismantling and applying grease to all the necessary parts. You can fast forward this if you don't want to watch it. Just before the 10-minute mark of this video, I stop cleaning, then start to fill the brake system with fluid.
A bit sticky and it was squeaking. Pull this forward. using some copper grease here. And then this. Crying out friggin' how they did this on the assembly line, I don't know.
So starting here, and for the next 4 minutes, I'll be bleeding the brakes. I mention this now because it's very repetitive. However, if you've never bled motorbike brakes before, it may be worth watching. For the purposes of this video, I haven't gone into great detail of how to bleed the brakes. I'm more than happy to make a dedicated video on that topic if people need it. So that's the end of the rear brake switch video. I hope you enjoyed it. This entire time, I've been working on the concrete floor on my hands and knees, and my back and knees are really starting to hurt now. I'm surrounded by all the right tools and equipment, and just thought I'll have to push through and service the front brake as well. So here you can see me topping up the front brake reservoir with fluid. Although we're working on the front brake now, the process of bleeding the system and then refilling is exactly the same as the rear brake. In order to keep this video short and manageable, I've heavily cut this process. As the video comes to an end, I'd like to take this opportunity to say thank you to all the people that have liked and subscribed to the channel. Your support really does motivate me to make more of these videos.